support to this union and to allow Sabrina and Mike to start their married life together, surrounded by the people dearest and most important to them. So welcome one and all who have traveled near and far. Sabrina and Mike, they thank you for your presence here today, and they now ask your blessing, your encouragement, and lifelong support for their decision to be married. A wedding is a celebration of the miracle of love. In love, we say not only, I love you today, but also, I promise to love you tomorrow, the next day, and every day, and always. In promising always, we promise each other time. Time to learn to love beyond the level of our instincts and inclinations, to love in stormy weather and in good. We change because of these promises. We shape ourselves according to them. We love in their midst, and we live differently because of them. Because we know we are in love, we can step beyond our fears. Because we have been chosen, we can rise above our insecurities. Marriage is the bond that sets us free. Our souls are protected. Our hearts have come home. So this, then, is part of the reason we are here today, to celebrate the union of two people whose hearts have come home to each other. There is a greeting to the mayonnaise jar and two coffees and mini tinkers. I guess I'll read it. A professor stood before his philosophy class and had some items in front of him. When the class began, he wordlessly picked up a very large and empty mayonnaise jar and proceeded to fill it with golf balls. He then asked the students if the jar was full. They agreed that it was. The professor then picked up a box of pebbles and poured them into the jar. He shook the jar lightly. The pebbles rolled into the open areas between the golf balls. He then asked the students again if the jar was full. They agreed that it was. The professor next picked up a box of sand and he poured it into the jar. Of course, the sand filled up everything else. He asked again the students if the jar was full, and the students again responded with a unanimous yes. The professor then produced two cups of coffee from under the table, and he poured the entire contents of the jar of coffee, effectively filling the empty spaces between the sand, and the students all laughed. Now, said the professor, when the laughter subsided, I want you to recognize that this jar represents your life. The golf balls are the important things. Your family, your children, your health, your friends, and your favorite passions. And if everything else was lost and only they remained, your life would still be full. Now the pebbles, they represent the other things that matter in your life. Your job, your house, your car. The sand, that is everything else. That's the small stuff. If you put the sand into the jar first, there's no room for the pebbles or the golf balls. So the same goes for life. If you spend all your time and energy on the small stuff, you will never have room for the things that are important to you. Pay attention to the things that are critical to your happiness. Spend time with your children. Spend time with your parents. Visit with grandparents. Take time to get your medical checkups. Take your spouse out to dinner. Play another 18 holes of golf if you play golf. There will always be time enough to clean the house, to fix the disposal. Take care of the golf balls first, the things that really matter. The rest is just sand. Now then, one of the students raised their hand and inquires, and this is probably where Sam is, he probably raised his hand. One of the students raised their hand and inquired what the coffee represented. The professor smiled and said, I am glad you asked. The coffee just shows you that no matter how full your life may seem, there are always room for a cup or two of coffee with your friends and each other. So Sabrina and Mike, marriage now, we're talking about marriage, that's all relates, okay? Never have coffee. Makes you less upset in the morning. Sabrina and Mike, marriage brings two people together, not only in the present, but in the present of their past. Of the lives we've led, the choices we've made, the lessons that have shaped and reshaped the changes of your heart. Therefore, when you doubt the relevance of your past, many times you will, or you don't understand your future, and most of the time you won't, remember, nothing we do in life is ever wasted or lost. Everything we know to this moment is a moment of value. Everything taught you something and was a step on the path that brought you here today. Your love for each other extends beyond the sea, wind, earth, and flame. Beyond all elements, it is greater than who you are, and yet it is meaningless without you. It is more powerful than your past, and yet your past is the foundation for your future. It has brought you here to this moment to become one in the eyes of God, family, and friends. Your love is the essence of your lives, so remember to do the simple and beautiful things that will make this love a lasting one. Communicate with one another. Focus on your goals. Plan for the things that are important to you. And make sure you do them. This love is to be nurtured. To be lived out in the fullest aspect of its freedom. In the simple ceremonies of everyday life. It is the realized hope of long-deferred plans. Finally, be thankful for one another. Love is always a gift. A great compliment is paid to you when you receive each other's love. It is another opportunity to love and to extend that love to the circle of your family and friends. Not everyone is given this opportunity. Not everyone in life experiences the joy of loving and being loved. And now, Sabrina and Mike, no other human ties are more tender and no vows more sacred than those who are now assuming. The vows you are about to speak are in verbal representation of a much deeper commitment. I think you can all hear me, and it's a reverberation of it. I'll speak more quietly. Sorry. May they be followed by loyalty and with devotion. So, Mike, you have Sabrina's hands in yours. Give her a squeeze. And then please look deeply just into her eyes as you repeat after me. Or, Mike, do you choose Sabrina to be your wedded wife, to live together in a holy state of marriage, and do you promise to love, honor, and cherish her from this day forward?
I do.
Sabrina, give Mike's hands a squeeze. Continue looking deeply into his eyes as you answer me. Sabrina, do you choose Mike to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holiest state of marriage, and do you promise to love, honor, and cherish him from this day forward? Thank you. Can I have the news, please? You promise not to throw them at me. Good job. All right. A wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of an inward spiritual bond that unites two loyal hearts in endless love. Michael and Sabrina, may these rings you are about to exchange today always remind you that it was love that brought you together, and it is love, your love, that will keep you together through all the seasons of your life. So Mike, please take your ring for Sabrina. Place it just at the top of the third finger of her left hand and repeat after me. Sabrina, I bring myself to you this day.
To share my life with you.
You can trust my love.
You can trust my love.
Word is real.
Word is real.
I promise to be a faithful mate.
I promise to be a faithful mate.
And to unfailingly share and support your hopes, When you fall, I will catch you.
When you fall, I will catch you.
When you cry, I will comfort you.
When you cry, I will comfort you.
When you laugh, I will share your joy.
When you laugh, I will share your joy.
Everything I am.
Everything I am.
And everything I have.
And everything I have.
Is yours.
Is yours.
From this moment forth.
From this moment forth.
And for eternity.
And for eternity.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
Let it signify the perfection of endless true love.
Let it signify the perfection of endless true love.
I am honored to call you my wife.
I am honored to call you my wife.
This day and forevermore.
This day and forevermore.
Sabrina, will you accept this ring and wear it with love and joy? Then you may finish. It's got to make your way to the Sabrina, please take your ring for wife. Place it just at the top of the third finger of his left hand and repeat after me. Mike, I bring myself to you this day to share my life with you. You can trust my love, for it is real. I promise to be a faithful mate and to unfailingly share and support your hopes, dreams, and goals. I vow to be there for you always. When you fall, I will catch you. When you cry, I will comfort you.
When you cry, I will comfort you.
Then don't cry your eyes away. When you laugh, I will share your joy. Everything I am and everything I have is yours from this moment forth and for eternity. I give you this ring as the symbol of our unity. It represents the greater circle of the life we share. I will always love you, appreciate you, and be proud to call you my husband. Right, can you accept this ring from Sabrina and wear it with love and joy? You may finish placing the ring on his finger. Mike and Sabrina, having pledged yourselves to one another before your family and friends, and having demonstrated this commitment to one another through the exchange of vows and the giving of rings, it is now my great honor and privilege to pronounce you husband and wife, Mike and Sabrina.